I feel very proud of myself that I'm not like the rest who take for granted this voting. It is very important, and I'm happy that I can exercise this right. Many generations before me were denied this opportunity, and I'm very fortunate to be part of a generation that is benefiting from exercising our constitutional democratic right. We have now voted, and once the stations are closed, the waiting period starts. So we'll wait, and the South Africans will tell us what they've decided. If the Sebokeng people want to stay in the debt environment, they stay in. If the people want to continue unemployed, if the people want to continue landless, if the people want to perpetuate the instituted corruption, they must continue to vote for the same party they've been voting for. So if you need change, the EFF is the way to go. And whatever numbers we'll receive from our people, we'll welcome them with both hands. It's a mandate. Even one vote count. We'll accept that those are the results, and this is what the people of South Africa feel about the EFF. Everyone has worked very hard. There's no one in the EFF who hasn't worked very hard. They continue to work because even now, they are fetching elderly people, bringing them to the stations, returning them back home safe. They will rest when the voting station closes. So we are hard at work, and we will continue to work until the last ballot paper is counted. All party agents must remain vigilant, must guard the EFF vote, because we know we're dealing with facts from the other side. They can steal our votes. So where there is no party agent of the EFF, we call upon people of South Africa to tweet us, to Facebook us, to Instagram us, to SMS us, and tell us that they voted. They didn't see EFF, a party agent or a table where they voted. Will immediately deploy party agents to go and look after the EFF vote. The last point I want to make is to thank the. There was some IEC staff member who said to my wife, she must take out a nail so that they put a mark. And I found that bizarre, because I said to her, where is that written in the rules that women who've got long nails can't vote? We cannot have such a patriarchal arrangement happening inside the voting station. And the electoral officer came and said, there is no such a thing. She can vote with her name. But the person who puts a mark on people, she's got a scissor there. And then she gives people scissors to take their nails out. So I'm not sure how many people's nails were taken out. It must never be costly for people to vote. Because to put nails is money. And for someone to give you a scissor to take out the nail, are they going to pay for it? So it can't be. When we ask for a rule, then only then they say, no, we can put the mark. We don't run elections through a common sense. You ought to know the rules by heart. Because when you are challenged, you can't produce anything. It's clear that you are using your emotions, your feelings, to decide what needs to happen. The next thing they are going to say, women must take out whips because they want to see if it's really them on the ID and all such nonsensical things. It's that small like that. Before you know it, it's something that is institutionalized. It must be challenged even now. But the process was smooth and quicker. And I'm happy that the IC seems to be organized, especially here at Mponaya. I've not been to other stations.